Financial Sense Insider is a premium subscription service of PFS Group. The following is a free preview of today's Insider interview.
A lot of economists are pointing out that the traditional economic models are no longer relevant and that there is a transformation taking place even among the elite economic institutions and the thinkers that spend a lot of time putting together economic information and modeling it and trying to figure out how to apply this for policy. I recently attended a speech by William White, who is at the OECD, and he was referring to how a lot of these models are outdated and went largely into the efficacy and the meaning and importance of looking at the economy as a complex adaptive system. Joining us on the show today is Milan Zeleny, and he has written just a fascinating paper on this idea called The Machine-Organism Dichotomy and Free Market Economics Crisis or Transformation. Milan, I want to give your background just for a bit here, because I know that you are a professor of management systems at Fordham University, and you were ranked as the number one among Czech economists, according to the Hirsch Citation Index. You've written a number of books on this idea of evolutionary economics, and I know that this is something that you've been thinking about and writing for quite a while, this transformation that's taking place among academia with regards to how we view the markets and the economy. Would you mind explaining this difference between viewing the economy as a machine versus an adaptive organism?
The machine concept is based on the construct made by humans. So we feel comfortable with machines because we have created them. Machine essentially is an input process output mechanism, where if you put input, then you get some response. And if you repeat the same input, you should get the same response. Organism, on the other hand, does not behave like a machine. And we have problems with organisms because we have not created them. We don't know enough about self-production and self-organization. And we don't know what living really means, and so on and so forth. So there is a fundamental difference between the two. And we don't view usually systems which we deal with as organisms, because, as I said, we are not comfortable because we have not created them. And so we tend to look at economies as machines. And that is causing problems because, as you know, the economies have been functional on the transition from sort of prehistoric living beings way before the economists emerged and these systems were subjected to evolution. And so there is now an increased interest in looking into this, because what we are seeing is that we are making certain inputs, certain efforts, certain stimuli, and so on. And yet the system doesn't seem to respond properly because it has learned, it has adapted, and it has taken its own course, and we are uncomfortable about that. In terms of governmental interference, clearly, if you do not see these kinds of long-term transformations, then you are handling anything which you have in the economy as a short-term cyclical crisis. And you are hoping that you will make some sort of speed up of the situation. But we don't have any reliable tools which would make a distinction between long-term transformation and short-term cyclical crisis. So if there is a change in employment or unemployment, we do not know what part of it belongs to something very cyclical and what part of it belongs to this irreversible long-term transformation.
What is the solution as you see it? What are some of the policy responses that you think need to be made at this point to, I suppose, rectify some of the problems that have been created?
Hi, everybody. John Loeffler here. You know, you've just been listening to a free preview of the Financial Sense Insider Premium Edition. Do you need help making sense of the market? I mean, you've heard the old adage, it's a jungle out there. Well, you know, you can join our premium weekday service and you'll gain access to leading experts, analysts, and market technicians on what's driving the markets, the economy, and your future. You can get all of that by subscribing today at financialsense.com. That's financialsense, S-E-N-S-E, like you're trying to make sense of something, .com. And click subscribe to join our premium weekday service. You won't regret it.